morning, again in this chapter 3, we are going to learn about here is the matter few, is the matter pure, under this we are learning solutions. We are learning, first point is the solutions. So, what are these solutions? Solution means when two or more components, minimum two components required. Two or more components. Component means a substance. A substance is called a component. A pure substance is called a component. When two or more components mixed together. So, in that mixing process, if the components are uniformly distributed with one another and forming a homogeneous mixture. So, that homogeneous mixture is called solution. When two or more components mixed together uniformly, evenly, that is called distributed evenly with one another and forming a homogeneous mixture is called solution. So, solution is a homogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture of two or more number of components. This is called a solution. So, in this solution, one is a solute, second is a solvent, third is forming the mixing. So, in this case, solute means the component which is in a small quantity. Component which is in small quantity, means small amount, small quantity. Solvent means the component which is a large amount. Component which is in large quantity. Large quantity. So, second point, the component which is dissolved, is called solute. The component which is dissolving, is called solvent. So, the component which dissolves is called solute and dissolving one is called solvent. Okay. So, this is the two components are there, solute and solvent. A solution has two components. A solution has two components. What are the two components? Solute and solvent. Solute means the compound which is in a small quantity. Solvent means which is the compound which is a large quantity. Say for example, 10 grams sugar dissolved in 100 gram water producing 10 grams sugar solution. 10 grams sugar solution. So, here in this case, sugar is in small amount, so it is called solute. Water is a large amount, it is called solvent. It is called solvent. Suppose if we take 10 gram water, 1000 gram sugar. In this case, what happens? Water is a solute, sugar is a solvent. Sugar is a solvent. So these are the components you can find. So different types are there, solute and solvent. So these solutions may be liquid solutions, gaseous solutions, solid solutions, or different types are there. So air is a type of solution. It is a homogeneous mixture of carbon dioxide, hydrogen gas, a little bit, oxygen gas, nitrogen gas, all the other some unwanted gases are also present, like a neon, argon, like these other gases are present. So all these gases are uniformly distributed, therefore it is a homogeneous mixture, it is a gaseous solution. Suppose take the 10 gram sugar and 100 gram water, it is a liquid, solution is in a liquid state. Suppose 10 gram water, 1000 gram sugar, it is a solid solution. Solution is a solid state. Okay, so like these different types of solution you can find. Now, let us see this. So the compound which is a large amount, it is called solvent. The compound which is a small amount is called solute. So here is one more point you must keep in mind. Solute is another way you can give the statement. Solute means the component which is dissolving, which dissolves. The compound which dissolves the solute is called solvent. The compound which is dissolving is called solute. Dissolving component is called solute. Dissolves. Dissolving component is called dissolvent. Solvent component. So, second point. What are the characters? Solute losing its physical state sometimes. If it is solid state, converted to liquid state. So solute loses its physical state. Sometimes if it is a liquid state, not losing. Solvent retains its physical state. Suppose here water is a liquid, after mixing together, again solution is also a liquid state. So the solvent retains its physical state, but solute losing its physical state. Second point, we cannot separate the solute from the solvent just by filtration. We cannot separate the solute from the solvent just by filtration. Third point, solute and solvent do not react chemically. They do not react chemically. Understanding? So solute retains its properties and solvent also retains its properties. So what I say, solute not losing its properties, solvent also not losing its properties in the mixing state. That is all. Now see this example. Sugar when dissolved in water gives a solution. The solution is a liquid solution. So they can say sugar is a solid, that sugar losing its solid state into liquid state. But whereas water is a liquid, again remains in the liquid state in the solution. Liquid state in solution. So like that you can say, so 1 gram of copper sulfate is a blue colored crystals. And just to take 1 gram copper sulfate crystals, add it to the water. What happens? That converted to solution. The solution attains blue color. So here in this case, the copper sulfate losing its crystal state into liquid state. But it is not losing its blue color. It remains a blue color. So it is a sulfate only, copper sulfate. But whatever water is gaining blue color. So at the same time, it retains liquid state. It retains a liquid state. So a solution of sugar is prepared by dissolving sugar in water. That is called aqueous sugar solution. You say aqueous sugar solution. But in this case, what is saying? Water dissolved in the sugar. Then you can say sugar aqueous solution. Aqueous sugar solution, here is saying sugar aqueous solution. So opposite. So you can write. Suppose here the solution contains saying solvent, yeah, the solvent is alcohol, it is called alcoholic solution. If solvent is a benzene solution. Okay, if a solvent is a kerosene solution, you say the word is which is solvent. So here is the aqueous solution means, suppose we are having sodium chloride dissolved in water. Sodium chloride is a solute, water is a solvent. So it is called aqueous sodium chloride solution. Aqua means water. So sodium chloride dissolved in the water. So that's why it is called aqueous sodium chloride solution. Suppose here is a, for one example, naphthalene dissolved kerosene. Then what is a kerosene naphthalene solution? A kerosene naphthalene solution. Like that you can say the word. Now next one is, so understand here, what are the characteristics of the solution? Here the characteristics, first point, solute losing its physical state, not colors, physical state, and retains all its properties. Solvent remains in the liquid state. Solvent not losing its physical state. Solute losing its physical state. Solute is not losing its properties, and solvent also not losing its properties when they are present in the solution state. Third point, we cannot separate a solute from the solvent just by filtration. We can say evaporation, some other process are there, but simple filtration, we cannot separate the solute and solvent. That is one. Next point, if the solution kept for a long time, it may be 10 hours, 1 day, 10 days, like that. Solute and solvent not separating. They are not separating. They remain in the mixed state, homogeneously in the mixed conditions. So we cannot separate this solute and solvent even if we put the long time resting state. Understand again? That is the property, you can see. One interesting property solution is that solute particles scatter the light, but the solute particles are very small. Very small means less than 1 nanometer size. Then they cannot oppose the passing of light through the solution. That's why very dilute solutions, there the light is not scattered, the light passing through the solution. If the solute component is large amount, then the light some extent scattered, the light scatters in concentrated solution. Light is not scattered in the dilute solution, light passing through the dilute solution, but in concentrated solution, light is not passing properly, it is a scatter, some amount of light scattered. Say for example, seawater is a concentrated water. So in that case also, if I light passing through the water, but still some light scattered in the solution. So here it depends upon the concentration, the light is scattered or not scattered. If it is a homogeneous state, dilute solutions, light is not scattered, light passing through the solution. If it is a highly concentrated, then some extent the light scatters. The light scatters while passing through the solutions. So now, why? Because the solute particles are very small in size, that is less than 1 nanometer. Less than 1 nanometer, that's the reason. Next point. What would you happen if you add a little more solute to a solvent? Suppose if I go on adding solute to the solvent, what happens? The concentration increase. Concent means amount of solute given in the amount of solvent. So the concentration increases. If you go on adding, what happens? At a certain point, the solute not dissolving in the solution. The solute not dissolving in the, means the solvent not dissolves the solute more. So in that case, the solute settled at the bottom. Solute settled at the bottom. So in that case, you find what happens? The solute which is settled at the bottom remains constant, but not the same solute. Because one side solute breaking into particles like a ions or molecules. The molecules enter into the solution. What are the particles already present in the solution? They convert into solid state and reaches to the bottom. So there is a cycle. So that cycle occurs continuously day and night. What happens? So the solid breaks into individual particles, enter into solution. The particles in the solution again convert into solid state. The process continues. The process continues. But the same amount of solid present at the bottom, the same amount of solute present in this solution, that remains same. But only cycling, physical cycling takes place. That is, liquid state converted to solid state converted liquid state, that is happening to the solute, not to the solvent. Okay, next, understand here. How do you understand the property solutions? Yes, you see the properties of the solutions. Understanding. So what are the properties here? First point, solute is small amount, solvent is large amount. Second point, solute losing physical state, solvent not losing its physical state. Third point, solute cannot be separated from the solvent just by filtration. Fourth point, solute retains its own properties, solvent also retains own properties. Okay, next point, since the solute particles are very small, in a dilute solution, the light can pass in through the solution. But if the constant goes on increasing more and more, some amount of light may scatter. Some amount of light may scatter means they touch the particles and reflecting back. So that is, it comes under the scattered light. Okay, so these points you must keep in mind. Next point here, if the some amount of solute is some means at certain concentration crosses, the solute not dissolving the solution settle at the bottom. So that indicates saturation. Now let us see concentration of the solution. What is meant by concentration? What is meant by concentration? Concentration means the amount of solute, it may be some x moles of solute or x grams of solute, some x liters of solute, like whatever may be, that is called the amount of solute present in a given solution or dissolved in a given solvent is called concentration. Concentration means the amount of solute dissolved in the solvent or given solution. So the amount of solute present in a given solution is called concentration. This concentration may be dilute or concentrated. So dilute means relative, compared to relative value. Relatively, solvent is, means when you compare the two solutions. See, for example, in one case, 10 gram dissolved in 100 gram water, for example. Here is a 10 gram solute. In another case, 100 gram, we'll take this 1000, and 100 gram dissolved in 1000 gram solvent. This is a solvent. So, compare these two relatively. Relative to the second solution, first one is called dilute solution. Relative to the first one, second one is called more concentrated solution. So, concentrated means here, actual word is concentration means some amount of solute present in a given solution called concentration. Here, concent 10 gram per 1000 gram solvent. Okay, now in this case what happens, 100 gram in 1000 gram solvent, this concentration, but relative, compare with one another, in that case you can say which one is dilute, which one is not dilute. So first one is a dilute, relative to the second one. Compare the second one, this is value. Understand here? Suppose the 1 gram is 1000 grams. Compared to the 1 gram, second is more concentrated. So compared to the second one, first one is called dilute. So like that, this is a dilute means a relatively less amount of solute dissolved in the solvent. Relative means comparative value. Relatively less amount of solute dissolved in solvent. It is called dilute solution. It is called dilute solutions. So, for example, 1 gram of sugar dissolved in 50 gram water, 30 gram sugar is added same amount of water. It is a 1 gram sugar dissolved in 30 gram water. In another case, 30 gram, sorry, 50 ml water. Now another case, 30 gram sugar dissolved in 50 ml water. So here what happened in these two cases? The first case is called dilute solution. Second one is called concentrated, more concentrated. So is the less concentrated, more concentrated. So relative to the second one, first one is called dilute solution. Which of the solution is called a dilute solution? And which one is a concentrated? First one is a relative to the second one, first one is a dilute solution. Relative to the first one, second one is a more concentrated solution. So like that you have to compare the relative value. The concentration is a relatively more concentrated, less concentrated, like that. So based upon this concentration, we are classified the solutions of three types. Let us see those. Based on the concentration, solutions are three types. One, saturated solution. Second, unsaturated solution. Third one is super saturated solution. First one, saturated solution means some amount of solute dissolving the solute at maximum amount. Maximum is that solute not dissolving at the bottom. So maximum at a given temperature. So at a given temperature, the maximum amount of solute dissolved in the solvent, then it is called saturated. The maximum amount of solute dissolved in the solvent at a given temperature is called saturated solution. Unsaturated means the amount of solute is dissolved in the solution less than saturated. Suppose your saturation is 100 gram, 1000 gram is saturated, but here is a less than 100, maybe 60, 70 or 80 or 50, like this. Less than the amount present in the saturated state is dissolved in the solution is called unsaturated. So the amount of solute less than the saturated state, the amount of solute present in a solution less than the saturated state at a given temperature is called unsaturated solution. Next, super saturated means the solute present more amount than saturation, more amount than saturated solution, then it is called super saturated. Suppose if you add 10 gram sugar in a water, 10 gram sugar in a water, what happens? The sugar will dissolve. You keep aside, first one. Second one, if you go on adding sugar to the 100 gram water, go on adding 1 gram, 2 gram, like this, 60 gram sugar dissolved in the water, and if you add 61 gram, that last gram not dissolving in the water, it settled at the bottom. Now max amount is how much? 60 gram. Max amount is 60 gram. So in the first case, just we are adding only 10 grams. But in second case, we are adding 61 gram. Out of 61, 60 grams dissolved in the water, only 1 gram settled at the bottom. In the third one, we are go on adding 100 gram sugar in 100 gram water, and just you are by providing heat energy, that 100 gram dissolved in the water, then slowly cool down, then make it cool it slowly, then you find 100 gram sugar dissolved 100 gram water. So here is the 60 gram is the makes the saturated solution, because 1 gram settled at the bottom indicates saturated solution. Second one is the, here no solute is settled at the bottom, only complete dissolved, so it is called unsaturated. And supersaturated means large amount, more than this 60 grams dissolved in at a temperature, so that is called unsaturated, supersaturated. So supersaturated is a unsaturated, unstable solution. Supersaturated is a unstable, means whenever you make some disturbance, then again whatever the excess amount, excess means more than 60 grams dissolved, that again convert into solid state. So that's why it is called unstable, so supersaturated solution is a unstable solution. So based on the concentration, solutions are three types: saturated, unsaturated, supersaturated. Saturated means the maximum amount of solute dissolved in the solvent at a given temperature. At a given temperature is called saturated solution. And unsaturated means the amount of solute dissolved in the solvent is less than the saturated state. Less than the saturated means it is called unsaturated solution. Supersaturated means the amount of solute dissolved in the solution more than the saturated state. More than the saturated state is a supersaturated, is a unstable solution. Supersaturated, unstable. When we make some disturbance, the excessively dissolved means more than 60. So excessively dissolved solute again settled at the bottom in the form of a solid state. So that is the way you can say concentrations. Okay. Suppose if a solution is provided here, so we are adding a pinch of sugar in the sugar solute in the solution, it dissolves. What indicates that solution is called unsaturated solution. Suppose you are provided one solution in test tube, then solute is provided. If you add a little bit solute in the solution, that goes directly to the bottom, not dissolve, that indicates it is a saturated solution. If you provided solution already, some solute settled at the surface of the solution, not inside, at the bottom. Some solute settled in a solid state at the surface of the solution indicates it is a supersaturated solution. So like that, we can identify the saturation, unsaturation and supersaturation solutions. How do you prepare the saturated solution? Suppose you take the 100 gram of water in a cup. 100 gram of water or 100 ml of water in a cup. Then add sugar, or you take the salt. You take just salt, sodium chloride salt. Add gram after gram. Gram after gram, you go on adding and stirring. Adding. So you will see, at last pinch, means last 1 gram, settle at the bottom, not dissolving. Then up to that point, how many grams we are added to the solution? So that is called its concentration, and now it is called saturated solution. That means when no more solute can be dissolved in the solution, when no more solution can be dissolved in the solution, okay, at a certain temperature, temperature is important, because the temperature changes, again that may be dissolve less or dissolves more. So that is it. That's why you can say mention the word at a given temperature. So it is said to be saturated solution. So when no more solute dissolve in solution, okay, at a certain temperature is called saturated solution. A saturated solution cannot be hold anymore solute at a certain temperature. If the temperature changes, the amount of solute may settle at the bottom, may dissolve. Means whenever the temperature changes, the solution may become saturated solution, changes into unsaturated solution, or may convert to super saturated solution. Suppose a saturated solution is defreezed. What happens here? When the temperature is reduced, then convert to super saturation. Suppose if we add this saturated solution when it is heated, providing more temperature, then convert into unsaturated zone. So like that, we can say this. This is just because of the, as the temperature changes, the space between the water molecules changes. When water molecule changes, so that may dissolve more solute or may dissolve less solute. So depends upon that. Suppose a temperature is reduced to 4 degrees centigrade to the water. What happens? The space between the molecules is decreases, so it dissolves very little amount. So here the saturation amount is very less. Suppose take this same water to the room temperature, it dissolves more for saturation. When you put in a high temperature for about 67 degrees, then again it dissolves much more amount. So as the temperature increases, the space between the water molecules increases, the solubility increases, the amount of solute dissolves can increases. So here the solubility changes.